Don't listen to people with questionable morals who want to tell you that the EFF leaders are disrespectful of people who do not respect themselves. Why do you want me to respect a man who sleeps with children who are the size of or the age of his daughters? What is there to respect? Why do you want me to respect a man who's called a cupcake by his own grandchildren? What is there to respect? Why do you want to listen to the ANC that gave Johannesburg municipality to a man who was accused of crimes? Removed a man who was delivering to the people of Johannesburg, despite his ideological concoction and confusion, service delivery was his priority. You replaced a man who loved the people of Johannesburg with a man of being suspected of crimes. When such a man goes and work with drug lords, and when such a man goes and work with convicted criminals, you now start asking questions as to what really happened. Those are the people who must tell the EFF how to treat themselves, how to treat a president with questionable morals. These are the people who think they can tell the youth of South Africa on how they should conduct themselves. Today, Johannesburg is a crime scene. It doesn't matter how many legal letters they can write. Johannesburg is a crime scene. And therefore, the supporters of Ramaphosa, the supporters of the ANC, who think they've got some chicken morality to tell us how we should address their president, they must first go and address their mess in Johannesburg, where gangsterism has hijacked the municipality, where criminality has hijacked the municipality. One of the senior employees of Johannesburg property was told that she must deliver the tender of Sandton Gautrain station back to the same company that Mashaba was investigating, because those who are presiding over those entities, they said they want 200 million out of that transaction. Therefore, a terminated company must be reinstated so that a criminal syndicate can get 200 million out of that reinstatement of that contract. Those are people who claim to have morals, who can tell us how we must conduct ourselves. The same people who want to put the Sikh on the scooters in the Eastern Cape, and the people of Eastern Cape want to complain like they are helpless, including the chairperson of the EFF in the Eastern Cape wants to complain like you are helpless. We want to tell the government of Eastern Cape, take those scooters and give them to municipalities. They can use them to deliver mails and bills. Because any of those scooters, if they are found in the villages claiming that they are coming to fetch a sick person, fighters, you know what to do with such behavior. I will not tell you now. I will tell you in our own space and privacy. But don't complain like you are helpless. Take it upon yourself to show the Eastern Cape government that you don't want those scooters. If it means you physically removing them from the streets of Eastern Cape, do so. Because we are not going to allow any government to dehumanize our people, to perpetuate the indignity of African people when we are here. Let's do everything in our power to defend the dignity of African people, like the 1976 generation did. So the challenge of 1976 in the immediate was Afrikaans as a medium of instruction. Eastern Cape, EFF, your immediate challenge is the scooters. deal with the scooters the same way the 1976 dealt with the nonsensical apartheid regime. Don't be scared of death. Don't be scared of prison. Don't be scared of being isolated if it means restoring the dignity of a black child. We are here today to say to the 1976 generation, we will never forget you. The same way we will never forget the Feast Must Fall generation. We are the youth that are inspired by fearless generations. We are inspired by the 1944 generation. We are inspired by the Steve Biko generation. We are inspired by the 1976 generation, by the 1979 generation that formed COSAS. We are inspired by the defiant youth, Isidamlilo of 1985. Those are the Sianyofa youth which put the last nail that forced de Klerk, the murderous de Klerk, to declare that all political parties are unbanned and the exiles can return. Those are the people who inspire us. Not a man who is an adopted child of a white Minel family. You must know Ramaphosa for who he is. When Ramaphosa took office, we said, we'll treat you with respect. We want a dignified parliament. We want a dignified space to fight politics. But Ramaphosa is doing exactly what Zuma did. What is the point of not treating him the same way we did with Zuma? It was the same fools, by the way, who said to us that we are disrespectful to Zuma. It was the same fools, by the way, who said our conduct in parliament was unacceptable when we demanded that Zuma pays back the money. It was the same fools that said to us, no, Zuma cannot be removed from office. Later on, to join us. Why? We are an advanced detachment of the revolution. We are ahead. We are not called commissars for nothing, because we are the doctors of this sick society. So we shouldn't be worried of the orchestrated noises that we hear. They are not real. We must focus on healing the sick society. It is only a sick society that can elect a president who instigated the murder of 37 unarmed people who were asking for shelter, who were asking for food, who were asking for a living wage. They never committed crime. You come and want to condemn us for calling him a bastard.